Hi, everybody. This is Rich. It was so great being a part of a dynamic group of people. This has been challenging and rewarding for me. As you know, midway through the ALF process, I lost my best friend. I would love to be talking about all the other good things that I've experienced with the team and my newfound friends and colleagues, but I find myself having to follow my heart. To some degree, I know we have all experienced loss of a loved one. Mary was my heart and the depth and breadth of my soul. My sweetheart from high school days. Along the way, we have two beautiful daughters, a military career, a handsome grandson, just like his papa, a life only lovers could ever understand. Mary and I had a beautiful life and a lot to be thankful for. Maybe she was too young to be taken away from me, as I was hoping. Maybe I was hoping to hold on to her forever. Maybe for all the selfish reasons, but when you're in love, all is right. I learned that life can be fair. Just as it was yesterday, I have all the memories, all the dreams we have had together. My heart is broken, and a part of me forever be abandoned. The best memories I have of her and us are the good times. Mary bore the life of a Navy wife while I was sailing the seas. She was the anchor of the family. She was the mother, the dad, repairman, and letter writer. I recall when she called me while the USS Coral Sea, we were transiting the Atlantic Ocean into the Mediterranean Sea. And just to remind me that the washing machine that I didn't get repaired, she fixed the problem with the washing machine. She was so excited that she forgot to tell me about our newborn daughter, Amber, by the way, who's now in the Navy, along with her sister, Richland. So, shortly, I thought about this. I called her back to ask her, how are you doing? Are you ready to give birth? Mary responded, are you nuts? Amber was born 12 days ago. I always miss her, and, you know, her laughter, her jokes, and mostly her warm smile. But because of my belief in the goodness of others, that I will always have support and trust. Because of each of you here in the present, I can call on you. You and you. Each day I see Tori, Cookie, Steve, James, Suda, Randy, Betsy, Dan, Amy and Amy, John, Doris, Joseph, my buddy, John, Wilmont, Ryan, Larry, Heather, Charmaine, Mario, Peg, Christy, Greg, and my man Sam. But today, believe it or not, I am in a better place because of all that we have accomplished together as a team, the relationship that we have built and fostered. 11 months ago, I only knew a few of the members in the group or in our class. Now I know all of you a little more. I've gained a deeper respect and appreciation of the relationship that we have fostered, and I appreciate being adopted into my new found family. I've experienced a lot of positive things. A week-long conference in the wilderness taught me that getting to the summit is not the most important thing. The journey together is really where the learning and growing are done. That journey reminds me of how, you know, the story of flock of geese migrate and how they form a V with a leader at the point. The geese take turns at being the point bird, a leader. AFL has taught me that you can't always be the leader, or you don't always need to be the leader, that you must respect your limitations. Or just like I had to depend on my wife to be the heart and the head of the household when I was at sea, I've learned to trust others to sometimes take the point position. This lesson on leadership allows us to always keep the best person up front, and in the end, that leads to a rewarding and enriching experience. I have the honor of being the principal of Carvers Bay High School. One of the mission of the high school is to help develop young minds into being good citizens. I thank my ALF cohort for the journey. I've now learned to trust the process. Right, Sam? Trust the process. I'm gonna miss you guys. Hope to see y'all soon. Again, thanks. Love you guys. Looking forward to working with you in the future.